Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to insert an image into SolidWorks. And the reason that this can be important is that if you've been using CAD software, you know that everything begins in the 2D environment, where you have to start out with a sketch before you can even convert it into a solid body or surface. If you think about it, an image gives you a starting point or a reference so that you can more accurately trace a line or curve against. In the real world, most consumer products you see most likely start up with a sketch image. This sketch image is normally created by an industrial designer where he or she primarily focuses on the ideation stage, which can involve proof of concept, the aesthetics, the function, and the manufacturability of the product. Once a design is chosen, then sketch images of the front, right, top views are then drawn out to be used downstream to be 3D modeled where more refinement can be done. My goal today will be to show you where you can find these images to sketch and how to insert and scale them correctly. Okay, if you'd like to follow along with the tutorial, head over to my website, ratha.sochenda.com/downloads to get your project files. I'll also leave a link in the description below. Now with that out of the way, let's get into it. Okay, if you head over to my website, under the headings, select Learn. Here I have a bunch of different free tutorials, links, and articles. But for now, we're just going to focus on the links for 2D sketches for 3D modeling. One popular place I use is Drawing Database. Here you can grab a bunch of different things such as cars, aircrafts, watercrafts, or weapons. So for example, this BMW 6 Series, you have all the views needed to start your 3D modeling. You have the right, the top, rear, and the front. Another place is Instagram. I follow somebody called Industrial Sketches, and there's a bunch of different sketches here that you can use to kind of start your 3D modeling. Unfortunately, sometimes you won't be able to find all views. They'll give you like an isometric view and a top view, but they won't give you like a right or front view. So you're gonna have to do some interpretation to get your sketches laid out correctly to make your model. Another place I use is Pinterest. I'll normally just type in car blueprints 3D modeling, and you'll find a bunch of different blueprints readily available that are free. Sometimes you can type in industrial design sketches, and you'll be able to find a few sketches that way as well. And another one, but it's paid. It's called theblueprints.com. They have a bunch of different things to model out. Check them out. It is paid, so just keep that in mind. So for this example, I've actually found a sketch image of a Predator drone, and I've already cropped into the correct size. I'll kind of show you a preview on kind of how I do that. That's kind of a video in itself, but I'll normally go into Photoshop. Open up the picture, then I'll go to crop, and then I zoom up on this real quick. Then I'll normally drag it, and then you see that the pixel shows up, and I'll drag it to the very top of the sketch, and then to the very right and the very left, so that it's cropped perfectly. Same with the bottom. So everything's kind of touching the part. So everything's kind of touching the sketch image itself. Then I'll save that out. And then I'll do that for the other views. And you can see that I cropped these perfectly, where this one's 31:23 by 6:52. And the other one is 17:23 by 6:52. So the right image is 17:23 pixels to the width, as far as the width. And as far as how tall it is, it's 652 pixels tall. Same with the top. So now that I have these cropped to the correct size, you'll see why I did that on purpose. So let's hop into SolidWorks, go to new, hit new part, hit okay. Because I use pixels, for some reason, if I use millimeters, it converts the pixels into millimeters. So I don't know how that all works, but it does a pretty good job. Let me show you real quick. So hover over to right, hit sketch, go to tools, sketch tools, sketch picture, and let's grab the right view since we're dealing with the right plane. Hit okay. And when you're importing images, depending on the size, they may take a while, so just hang on. You can see based off the sketch image, it snapped to the corner. And if you look at it, that is the very bottom part of the actual drone and the very nose of the drone itself. And right now, if you look over to the left where it says properties, you have 1723, you have 652. For some reason, it does a conversion, and that is what I like. And so one way to scale it right now, I like it scaled the way it is because it image came in with the same pixel count to match millimeters. Hopefully that makes sense. And then now, but if you didn't do it like that, let's say you grabbed a random image, you'll actually use the, make sure your enable scale tool is on. You'll just grab it to the front nose of the drone. And this is more of a, you know, rough approximation scaling method. And then you go over to the right and you'll go to the very back, and then you let go, and then you can type in what you need. So you can see 1722.9 millimeters, very close to 1723, but it's not 100% close, and I actually want it to be spot on. So I'm not going to use the enable scale tool method. So just hit exit out. I like it where it's at, so I'm just gonna hit, but before I hit okay, I'm actually gonna go to full image and change the transparency to 0.5. The reason why I do that is because when I sketch, I wanna be able to make sure that I can see my sketch through the image itself, so it's not blocking anything. Okay, I like that, hit okay. Now I actually wanna go to the front view, actually hit okay. And I want to go to the front view, hit sketch, same thing, go to tools, sketch picture, and let's look for the front, hit okay. Okay, it might take a minute, so just be patient. Deactivate the enable scale tool. You can see that it came in 31, 2, 3, 6, 5, 2. Go back to our window, you see that 31, 2, 3, 5, 6, 5, 2. So I like that. But the only thing is if I rotate over, it's not in the center. I actually want this to be in the center. So to do that, this is in the XY direction. So I wanna, and I know the width of this guy is 31, 2, 3. So I'll take 31, 2, 3 divided by 2. You can see it shifted over the wrong half, but no worries. Select in front of it and hit negative, and that will bring you to center. And then if I look at it and zoom up, you can see the right view and the front view intersect at the nose, and it's pretty accurate this way. So same thing, go to full image, transparency 0.5. Hit okay. Okay, now we have our front locked in and our right locked in. Now is to do the top. So hover over to your top plane, right click. Oh, before we do that, hit okay. Hover to your right, hit sketch, tools, sketch tools, sketch image or sketch picture. Let's go to the top, hit okay. And we wait. Okay, now that the top image has appeared, let's deactivate the scale tool. You can see it came in as 3123 by 1723, but you can see it's off to the right, so we're gonna do the same thing again. So it's in the X direction, 3123 divided by 2, and then we'll put a negative in front to shift it over to the left. And if I hit space, hit the top face here, you can see that it is right in the middle of my sketch. And then we go to full image, transparency, 0.5. Hit okay, hit the check mark. And there you guys have it. You can look at the alignment. It looks pretty spot on. So if you look at this line here and this line, you can see that they are pretty close in alignment. And then to take this another step further, I actually like to name my sketch images so that I don't get confused. Instead of saying sketch one, since I know sketch one is the right, I'll just double click that and say drone right. And then this is, double click it, drone front. Drone top. Okay, and the next thing I like to do now is actually put all these sketches in one folder. So how you do that is select the first sketch, hover to the last sketch, hold down shift and click, then right click, add new folder, and we're gonna name this drone layout sketches. So that when we draw all our other sketches, this will be in a separate folder and we won't get confused and mixed up. And we won't absorb any of these sketches as we sketch along. So that is pretty much it. Okay, so here we have a nice super clean sketch of a John boat that I'm actually working on right now. This is a nice clean blueprint, but let's say we don't have something like this. Let's say we have a bunch of different reference images like this here. You can see where I would tackle this is I would go off of the top view because it's the most flat view, but you have to take into consideration that this was actually taken by a camera where it actually introduces perspective and foreshortening, so that may skew the sketch layout, but it'll get you close. So one way I actually use this top view is, let me hop into SolidWorks real quick. So here is some of the surface modeling that I've done using the top view. So if I go into top view, hit show, you can see, and I hit edit, so you can see I actually drew a construction box for the top view of the John boat. And because I know some nominal dimensions, I was able to size that construction box accordingly and then scale the picture to get pretty close. You can see I actually kind of had to angle it a little bit and kind of figure out, okay, where is the end of the boat and where is the very front of the boat. So I got pretty close. So that's one way of doing it, is make a construction box around it and then scale accordingly based off of some nominal dimensions you have. Hopefully you guys learned a few things today. Sketch images can be used as a powerful approach when creating high quality 3D models. However, if you can also do the freestyle approach where you just jump right into CAD and start sketching as you please. However, I prefer starting with the analog approach where I started with a sketch image or a high quality hand sketch of all the necessary views that define the intended design. Then use CAD to convert it into a 3D model where the final details can be incorporated. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for the next video where I actually take these sketch images and convert them into a 3D model using some advanced surface techniques. If you want to see more of the behind the scenes stuff that is not on my YouTube channel, follow me on Instagram at Ratha.Sochenda. And as always, thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one, and later.